Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about gyrification and how the brain folds. Gyrification is the process leading to the formation of folds on the surface of the brain during the expansion of the brain in the fetal stage. These folds are made of sulci and gyri. Understanding how and why the structure form is important because it will shed light on the functioning of the brain and on the origin of certain neurological diseases. Before we start, let's summarize the different regions of the brain very roughly. Here, we find the outer cortex, the cortical gray matter, the white matter, the ventricular zone, and the ventricle. The cortical gray matter consists of neurons, and the white matter of the corresponding axons. The gyrification is globally driven by two complementary aspects of brain expansion, biomechanics and genetically determined cellular processes. From a biomechanical point of view, it is the stresses applied by brain expansion that initiate cortical filling. The anisotropy of the tissues causes the stencil forces to be distributed tenaciously upon expansion, initiating the folding of the surface. Then, the axonal tension exerted in the white matter turned the most connected areas to form the gyri. However, this first explanation does not yet allow us to understand the total complexity of the patterning of the grooves. From a cellular point of view, the multiplication of progenitor cells in the outer subventricular zone, and more particularly of basal glia cells, influences the formation of gyri. The cortical folds can be divided into several orders, which can be assimilated to the different ramifications. The fact that the structure of the primary fold is similar from one individual to another seems to show that genetic determinism is dominant here. However, in the higher order folds, biomechanical forces take over to form the small branches whose distribution seems random. The foundations are laid, but there is still much to learn about brain gyrification. Further simulation or other methods, such as the use of organoids, should allow us to refine our understanding of the phenomenon.